Hi, my name is Jimmy Vasquez. I'm the social policy specialist in UNICEF El Salvador, former economics analyst in UNDP El Salvador. And I'm gonna be sharing with you the experience on the multidimensional poverty index back in El Salvador. First, let me start by thanking to UNDP and to OFI colleagues for giving me this opportunity. I'm going to try to be brief. I only have 15 minutes, but it's going to be a challenge that due to this is a long story and it was a lot of process that we did back in El Salvador. Maybe you want, the first question that comes to the mind is why El Salvador decided to go for a multidimensional poverty measure. And let's go back to basically to 2009, and bear in mind that at that moment, Mexico was leading this this type of methodology in the region. And basically we share with them a lot of our doubts. But in the case of El Salvador, we did it because we had a lot of stuff going on. Firstly, we had these studies coming from the UN system, from UNICEF, UNDP, WFP, where we were seeing a situation that was politically and technically was a bit confusing, let's say. I'm gonna use the word confusing because basically what was happening is that El Salvador started to create a lot of social policy programs, and even though El Salvador was doing that back in 2005, 2006, the income poverty was going the other way that you would expect, Basically, it was going up instead of going down. So, but the main thing that was behind that is that the income poverty was based on the nutritional patterns that were observed in the urban and rural areas, basically back in 1967 and in 1973, respectively. So even though we have what we have is that the food consumption patterns were very different, but at the end, what we were seeing in that trend was the food prices index. What we were seeing in that precise moment wasn't the income poverty trend itself, but how was behaving the food prices index. So what we wanted to do, even though the government was doing a lot of social programs, the thing is that at the end, we were not using those indicators for measuring poverty. So we had to go from income to a multidimensional rationale. That's one of the reasons why we went to this multidimensional process. Then I would say that El Salvador was doing a lot of these social programs that we were that the government was launching were based on social indicators, so a lot of social indicators, not on the income poverty itself, but using, let's say, from the educational dimension, from the household dimension, how was the water and sanitation indicators and stuff like that. So it was more, let's say, it was multidimensional itself, but it was based on the type of indicators that were at the moment in the household surveys. So what I'm saying here is that even though El Salvador was doing a lot of multidimensional social mapping, it was based on the data availability. Yes. So what we wanted to provide to El Salvador was a way to measure in this multidimensional way, but based on the same sort of indicators, the same matrix of indicators. Yes. So Basically, we started this process in 2009, and one of the things that we did was trying to engage with another experiences. I said before, we went to Mexico and we look at the experience of Mexico with Coneval. We also wanted to know on the experience of Colombia, and at the end in 2011 we engaged in this political and technical process. Yes, so we started this project with the government of El Salvador. We launched a high level advisory council with the participation of the OFI colleagues, and basically what we went from having this technical discussions to create an Alcaide Foster methodology for El Salvador. So let's say that one of the things that I find one of the value added things that we did in El Salvador was that even though we knew poverty is multidimensional, we didn't know the dimensions. So who knows the dimensions? That's the question. And who else that who's been experiencing poverty? So what we did was we took the set of indicators that the household surveys were providing us. We basically went and make a lot of diagnosis about that. We arrived to a set of around 8 indicators that were from education, health, and livelihoods. And then we asked to the population that was living in poverty. We went to a lot of places in El Salvador. We went to we did a lot of focus groups around El Salvador with different populations in the mountains, in the coast, people living in slums, in the rural areas, because we wanted to know how was experienced poverty around the country. And from that very precise moment is that we knew how was living, what was the multidimensional experience of poverty in El Salvador. That was a challenge because we had a lot of qualitative analysis, but then we needed to come up with technical indicators, with indicators that we know that we can measure every year in the household survey. That was the second stage, and I would say one of the great things that the team back in El Salvador did, and I would say one of the that was great. That was a really good work that the team back in El Salvador did. So now we have all these experiences. Now we have all these indicators. Now we have all these testimonials of being living in poverty. What we need is to create an indicator. And there was an expression, for example, I'm gonna say it in Spanish because that is not as strong in English. But when we were asking about what is poverty for you, people were saying, "Look at where we live. We live hacinados como que fuéramos cuches." That's basically we're living overcrowding, like some sort of animals. So when people is saying that to you, and we are we wanted to create and we wanted to give that voice an indicator. Basically what we did is to look at a lot of indicators in the world, and then we said, okay, so what is saying these people in El Salvador is saying is that they are experiencing an overcrowding situation. And then we created an indicator for that. Basically, we came up with 8 indicators, and from that, using all the statistical analysis, we came up with 20 indicators. That's basically the dashboard of indicators that we have in El Salvador, and where is based the multidimensional poverty analysis. So that was a very, very challenging. That was very challenging, but I would say that is one of the, you know, sometimes we know that things are multidimensional, but we don't ask people. And if we don't ask people, we can't deliver human-centered public policies. What we wanted to create is a human-centered public policies, poverty eradication strategies that are human-centered, not based only on academics. It's not that I'm saying that you don't have to go to academics, you don't have to see papers. Of course, you have to do that. But it is important to see on how the people is feeling this. So I would say that's one of the things that this process, this participatory process for defining the dimensions in El Salvador was one good example for you guys that are going to be doing this kind of process in your own countries. Then what happened is that, I don't want to be long, I think I'm already around 10 minutes, but one of the things that happened was that this was discussed with one government, and then another administration came up. And that was a challenge, because once you've been talking for 5 years, for 4 years with an administration, and then another one came up, is running the executive branch, you have to start over. I would say it didn't happen, because we created this advisory council with people from El Salvador. So people from El Salvador, business people from the private sector, people from the academia, people from the NGOs, all of them were included in this process. And all of them were basically having this active discussion. So when the change of administration happened, it was already a national process. So what happened there was that we basically had to engage in some conversation with the new administration for almost a year, and then it was officially launched. So now El Salvador have one very good tool. I mean, one of the best tools in my view, one of the best tools to create preventive social policies rationale. I'm not talking about alleviating poverty. I'm talking about preventing poverty. That's the way you can do it, with this kind of modeling tool, simulating, using this tool, the MPI, in order to see how can you create a scenario so you can basically achieve SDG1 and all of that, and all of the SDGs, given that SDG1 is, I would say, the building block of all the SDG agenda. So basically, while El Salvador has this very strong tool, we are using it in terms of, we are monitoring how it's been behaving the multidimensional poverty. We have the monetary approach that's not included in the multidimensional approach. We have it because we need to see what is the trend, even though the things that I said, that the food basket and all the stuff that I said before, but that gives you a different rationale. That's more on the economic side. When you want to do social policies, that is more on the human capabilities. So we have to go to the multidimensional approach. And that's why this is very important to have it both measures. Right now, I'm UNICEF now, but basically what we are doing is that using the new administration can use this tool in order to see how many interventions they have to do in those deprivations that gives the most energy, that basically provides more energy to the MPI as itself, in the aggregate, you know. So that's very important it is important to measure, but it is, I would say, at this moment of my life, I'm going to recommend to you to go to have discussions on the measure side, but to go to the action. We are going to change the lives of millions of people if we go from measurement to policy. And that's basically what we have in this kind of tool. With multidimensional poverty measurements, basically is allowing to stay to the private sector, to the academia, to see things which income measurement does not show. That is the beauty of this. That is the beauty of what you are studying right now. So, blessings and un abrazo a todos.